same storm, and if Texas Republican Senator John Cornyn is right, likely same mess too. So, Senator, you fear a snow job is coming?
Well, I think this may be a sign, Neil. No one likes this health care bill, at least what we know of it. The version that Harry Reid will release tomorrow, I assume he will fill the amendment tree, the technical term for avoiding any other amendment. He'll try to jam it through between now and Christmas Eve. And like you said, no one has seen this final bill, but from what people know of it or suspect to be in it, I don't know of anybody who likes it on the right or the left.
Well, increasingly you're right on the left, Senator. What's rather surprising is not only is Ben Nelson apparently more against this than he was before, that is the Democratic Nebraska senator who they've been trying to woo, now talk that AFL-CIO President Rich Trumka doesn't like it. This one, the same day, moveon.org has been saying move on with this thing. It ain't cutting the mustard here. What do you make of all of this?
Well, I think, you know, the problem is, of course, this is a comprehensive bill that tries to remake one-sixth of our economy. And we know that Washington has not shown itself to be very good at comprehensive anything. And I think what the American people want, because they don't like what they've seen in this bill, is a step-by-step approach to deal with the problems. How about competition across state lines? How about medical liability reform? How about parity of tax treatment for employer-purchased insurance as opposed to purchased insurances purchased by individuals? Those are step-by-step approach.
Well, they've nixed the step-by-step stuff, Senator. So now what I want to know is maybe there's a method to this madness, that maybe the assurances Harry Reid is giving them is that, look, I'm stripping a lot of stuff out, I'm putting this in, I'm, you know, cooking this up, I'm taking this ingredient out, just to get something through the Senate, and we can work out these details with the House later on. What do you make of that, rumors of that, and whether he's changing any minds with it?
Well, of course, it is all rumors, but that's the coin of the realm here on Capitol Hill is rumors, and we don't know because we haven't seen the bill. Even those who, some of the senators said they support the bill, they haven't read it, according to some reports. But the problem is the basic core of this bill cuts about $500 billion from Medicare, including some benefits for seniors on Medicare Advantage, 500,000 of whom live in Texas. It also will raise taxes on small businesses and taxpayers of moderate income, and it will raise premiums on people with insurance.
So why are they then releasing both the bill and the CBO scoring of the bill on a Saturday in what will likely be the middle of a blizzard? I know in the famous animation, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, they darn near canceled Christmas, Senator. What now?
Well, it feels like they're trying to cancel Christmas, but there's still some hope. I think the best thing that could happen is we just stop this bill and we come back after the beginning of the year and try to work together on this step-by-step or incremental approach.
Well, but what if they say, but Senator, if I'm reading Harry Reid right, I don't know if he's playing Scrooge or whatever, he wants to keep all of you guys there through Christmas if need be, just to get this thing through, out, done, c'est la vie. What do you say?
No doubt about it. And, you know, we're hearing rumors that the House would not even, there wouldn't be even a conference committee between the House and the Senate to hopefully clean up and correct mistakes made by this rush to pass a bill before Christmas, that the House might just take up the Senate bill and pass it. I think the president and the majority here in Congress are desperate to pass a bill, any bill, and they really almost don't care what's in it.
Amazing. Senator, thank you very, very much. Man, oh man, where is Yukon Cornelius? Well, you need him. A little Rudolph.